Welcome to Analog Layouts. So today we are going to discuss the topic of antenna effects in VLSI. Let's start the video. So what is antenna effect? Why it is called antenna effects? So before going to the video, we will just go through the definition of antenna video. So antenna video is the manufacturing related problem. So whenever the chip metals are manufactured in a manufacturing time, so that time only we will face the antenna related problem. So antenna, it's not related to working wise related problem or post validated silicon problem, nothing. So it's the manufacturing related problem. This is the main key point for antenna effect. So during the chip fabrication, what will happen? The charges will be accumulated in the metal plate. So due to the charges accumulated in the metal plate, the gate oxide will be damaged permanently. So this is the definition for antenna effects. Then I will tell you with the real example how the antenna effects is forming. So first, what we are doing, so we will take one MOSFET circuit, anything, it's a CMOS or NMOS, any gate. Okay, suppose if the lengthy metal routed to a gate of the metal, so this is a lengthy metal, so usually we used to connect metal only. So usually whenever the lengthy metal is routed to a gate of any transistor, due to the fabrication process, etching will be done in the fabrication process. Unwanted materials and all, we used to etch. By using etching process only, we will remove the unwanted materials. So while doing etching, particularly plasma etching, what will happen? Charges will be accumulated in this metal plate. So it's a kind of positive charge, not a negative charge. So charges will be accumulated in this entire lengthy plate, which means lengthy metal. So this we used to connect as a input pin. So the charges will be flow through a low resistive path. So this is a high resistive path because it's an open circuit. So the low resistive parts towards the gate only, we have the low resistive parts. So the entire induced charges will directly go and hit the gate terminal. So too much charges is induced, so it is coming and affecting and hitting the gate terminal. What will happen that time? The gate oxide will be damaged permanently. So this is gate oxide, right? The gate oxide will be permanently damaged. So this is the cause of antenna effect, and this is the problem we are facing with antenna effects. So if you want to know very clearly how it is happening, so we'll do the cross sectional video. So this is a cross sectional of any mass. So this is source terminal, this is drain terminal, this is substrate, p substrate. So this is a gate oxide. So above this we have a gate terminal, right? So this is gate terminal. So this particular area is oxide, gate oxide. So how it will happen? Whenever the lengthy metal, see, lengthy metal, if it is routed to a gate area, charges same it will induced and it will come and hit this metal, this gate oxide will be permanently damaged. Have you any idea why particularly the gate oxide only it is getting damaged? So I'll tell you the reason. See, consider this is a gate metal. So this is a gate terminal, this is oxide metal, and one more below, this is substrate metal. So this is one metal, this is one metal, top level also one metal, bottom also one metal. So here we have a dielectric material, it's called oxide. So whenever between the two metal plate, one dielectric material, if we placed, so it can act as a capacitance, right? So at the time of manufacturing process or fabrication process, gate terminal act as a capacitance. So what will happen? The too much charges will induced in the metal plate. So if it is too much charges are induced and it is coming and getting to the gate terminal, the gate is a metal terminal, nothing will happen. Polysilicon will not get any affected, and substrate also, it's a metal. Okay, this will also not get any effect. But the oxide, it can act as a capacitance. So it's kind of floating net, so floating capacitance. So the capacitance of the oxide, which means the oxide only act as a capacitance layer. So the oxide will be permanently damaged. So this is the problem we are facing, antenna effect. Whenever there is an antenna effect, gate oxide will be damaged permanently. And one more thing, why source terminal and not drain terminal, it's not affected by the antenna effect? Because source and drain terminal doesn't have this kind of oxide layer below the, which what you say, beneath the source terminal. See here, this particular point we don't have any oxide layer. So this particular point we don't have any oxide layer. So because there is no oxide layer, that is why source terminal and drain terminal is not damaging while doing antenna effect. And one more reason is there why source and drain is not getting affected, in the sense, see whatever you take, suppose if you take P mass or N mass, any mass, suppose consider I am taking P mass. So this is P channel, this is P channel, here N well will be there. So one lengthy metal, it's connected to a gate of the transistor, sorry, source and drain terminal. This is source terminal, this is drain terminal. So here first region why the source and drain terminal is not getting affected, because there is no oxide layer present in the source and drain terminal, only gate only having the oxide layer. And why not the source and drain? One more second reason, see this is a P and junction, the P and N junction diode. This is a P diode, this is a N diode, so P N junction diode. Okay, so and one more P N junction diode. See two diodes are connected. So whenever the charge is accumulated in this plate, this diode will be in a reverse bias region. So reverse bias region usually diode will not conduct. Okay, so even though if it is a forward bias region also, what will happen, suppose if it is a reverse bias region, the diode will not conduct, so there will be no any current flow between this P drain terminal and the substrate terminal. Suppose even if it is a forward bias condition also, the diode what will do, it will conduct the material to the ground. Okay, so the diode will start conducting the whatever the voltage conducted by the diode, it will come to the ground terminal, and this will be through the substrate, it will be getting grounded to the substrate metal, right? So even though if there is any conduction, this terminal will not get affected, it won't damage. Okay, but why particularly gate is getting damaged? Because of the presence of this oxide layer. So oxide layer will get permanently damaged, because oxide layer can act as a capacitance. So that's the reason only the gate terminal is getting damaged, right? So before going to the next slide, one more time I will explain what is antenna. Whenever a lengthy metal connected to a gate of the transistor, so due to the manufacturing process, which means plasma etching. What is the manufacturing process? It's called plasma etching. During the etching process, particularly plasma etching, the charges will be accumulated in the metal plates. The charges, accumulated charges will directly go and hit the gate terminal. So what will happen, too much charges is getting from the through the metal, the gate is getting too much charges. So that time the gate oxide will be permanently damaged. Okay, the gate oxide will be permanently damaged. So this is the definition and this is the explanation of antenna. And in next slide, so we will see how the DRC and LVS, or else technology related file, how we can able to see whether there is an antenna effect or where there is a no antenna effect. See how the antenna can be calculated through the antenna ratio. So there will be a ratio called antenna ratio. By using the antenna ratio only, we can able to identify, or we can able to say whether the gate is getting antenna effect, whether the gate is not getting antenna effect. So for example, this is a 90 nanometer technology, so length is 90 nanometer. We are taking 90 nanometer technology. How the antenna effect, or else how we can calculate whether there is antenna or not? So here we have connected a lengthy metal, okay, which means 205 micron length gate metal we are connected, and length of the channel is 90 nanometer. So we have the general formula here. See, length of the metal into technology, this is a 90 nanometer, and divided by technology into length of the oxide layer. See, this is the oxide layer, right? Gate oxide we have here. So this is the oxide layer. So length of the oxide layer, length of the oxide layer is 200 nm. So here we have mentioned 200 nm length of the oxide. So while doing the calculation process, we are getting the result of 1025. See, the antenna ratio here we have with 90 nanometer. Below 1000, if there is a metal connected to a gate in the range of 1000, below 1000, then the antenna will not affect the gate terminal. But here in 90 nanometer technology, in 1025 we are getting, so compulsory there will be antenna effect is happening. So this is how we are calculating whether there is antenna or whether there is no antenna. See, the entire value, this 1000 or 1025, this length of the metal and everything is assumption For example, I am telling this is not a 100% value of 90 nanometer. For our understanding, I am telling. Okay, so for example, we have consider below 1000 there is no antenna. If it is exceeding above 1000, then we are facing antenna. It depends on the how lengthy metal we are connecting to the gate of the transistor. See, this is how we are calculating the antenna effect, whether there is antenna is present or not, by using antenna ratio. And then suppose we are facing some antenna effect or antenna related problem, okay, how we can able to resolve the problem. The first method, the master method, is going for a metal jumpers. So this is metal jumper. What is mean by exactly metal jumper in the sense? See, for example, only one metal diode is there. So this is called a M1 metal. M1 metal, here we are connecting to one gate of the transistor. See, this is one gate of the transistor we are connecting. So this is already manufactured. Sorry, this is already layouted, and here we are facing some antenna issue. So what we have to do, instead of going to the full metal with M1, we have to go with the metal jumpers, which means this is M1 metal, this is one more M1 metal. See, this is M1, this is also M1 metal. So here we have to connect one transistor. After that, what you say, the charges will be accumulated here, the charges will be accumulated here, here also charges will be accumulated, but the length of the metal here is very small, okay, while manufacturing M1, okay. Again, what we have to do, metal jumper, we have to use second one more process, we have to do with M2 metal. So this is M2 metal. See, while manufacturing M1, M2 will not be there. So this is the open path. Here there is no conduction. Whatever the charges is accumulating here, the charges will be here only. So the metal area, first it will calculate, the metal area is very small, and the gate area is, what you say, it is not reaching the antenna ratio. So there is no antenna. Again, M2 will be manufactured. At the time of manufacturing M2, only the charges will accumulated in M2 metal only, because M1 metal is already fabricated, okay. So only M2 metal will be there. At the time, the charges will be present only within this area only, okay. So that time, what will the DRC will do? Calculate with the M2 metal and as well as this gate oxide metal, gate oxide area and metal area. So this is the first method, going for metal jumpers or else going for higher metal is the first optional for the to resolve the antenna related issue. And one more thing, few of them, for if you are the interviewers or you have few of the interviewers, you may get the question from them, okay. The charges is presented here, how the charges is getting discharged? Or else, see, for example, M1 charges is accumulated here at the time of manufacturing M1. The charges is already accumulated in M1 metal, okay. So this metal, okay, no problem, it is going to the gate and it is discharging. And what about this floating metal? Floating metal, the charges will be accumulated, there is no point to discharge, still the charges will be present here only. Then how the charges will be getting discharged? In the sense, after manufacturing any metal, we will do planarization. In planarization, what we will do, usually whenever we are manufacturing any metals, metal will not be in a uniform structure. See, it will be kind of goose and bump structure, it will be manufactured. So after manufacture, what we will do smoothening process. Smoothening in the sense, see, this kind of up and down, some process variation is there, right? So we will do smoothening. Smoothening is called planarization. So while doing planarization and smoothening method, whatever the charges presented here, that will be discharged, okay. So this is the one after method. After manufacturing M1 metal, we will smoothening. After smoothening the metal, we will do planarization. Both are same process only, smoothening and planarization. After planarization, we will add some, again one more insulator layer here. So this will be SiO2 layer or any insulator layer here. After that only we will manufacture M2 metal. Again the same process, planarization and adding the insulator layer, it will be applicable for M2 also. So up to top metal the process will be same, but how the charges is getting discharged for M1, the floating net, I am talking about the floating net, not about the metal connected to the gate, I am talking about only the floating net. The floating net charges will be discharged through the planarization method. So going for the metal jumpers is the first method to prevent antenna, because what will happen, it is calculated through the lengthy metal only. So the lengthy metal, whenever the lengthy metal is connected, same metal M1, I am talking about M1 with the lengthy metal. So charges accumulated, the charges will damage the gate oxide. Here we are splitting the metal and we are going for the higher metal, that is called a metal jumper. Okay, we are jumping from one metal to another metal. This is the first method for an antenna related problem, to resolve the antenna related problem. And second method is called antenna diode. Antenna diode, this diode is a normal diode, there is no special manufacturing related diode or nothing. The normal diode, it's called antenna diode, because to prevent antenna we are placing this diode, that is why it is called antenna diode. See, this is all M1 metal, fully M1 metal. This length to this length is M1 metal. We are not going with the metal jumpers. Okay, so second solution, why we are going for a metal jumper. Suppose we have an area constraint, which means we have to use only metal area, metal 1 only we have access. There is no option for metal 2, metal 3, metal 4. We have to use M1. So there is no other chance, because even though if you are splitting and placing the metal, the charges will be accumulated in M1, because M1 will be manufactured throughout the chip in the same time only. So at the time of connecting only one metal with M1, we don't have any other access to go for higher metal. That time we have to go for an antenna diode. So antenna diode will be connected to the nearest place with the gate. Antenna diode should not be connected end of this terminal or end of this terminal. It should be placed to the very near to the gate terminal. For example, here I am drawing one diagram and I am explaining you. So this is a lengthy metal connected to the gate of the transistor, source and drain. So this is gate terminal. Antenna diode should be connected here. This is antenna diode, this will be grounded. Antenna diode should be connected with the reverse bias condition, not with the forward bias condition. Antenna diode should be connected to the nearer to the gate area, and it should be connected to the reverse bias condition. And again you will get the question, how the reverse bias diode will get conducted. And one more thing you want to know before going to the diode, in diode operation we have a reverse breakdown voltage. So whenever there is a very high voltage, or more than some more than some limited value of the voltage or current, if it is exceeding, in reverse bias condition also diode will conduct. So you have to see the diode reverse bias condition waveform. See, in forward bias condition diode will conduct here, and reverse bias condition also it will conduct, but the charges will be discharged in a particular time period. It will be discharged instead of time directly to the ground. So if you want to know how the reverse bias diode will work, you have to study with a PN junction diode reverse breakdown voltage. The topic name is called reverse breakdown voltage. Here the diode should not be connected with the forward bias. The diode should be connected to the nearby to the gate area, and it should be connected with the reverse bias condition. How the diode is conducting with reverse bias means you have to study what is the reverse breakdown voltage and what is the reverse breakdown junction for the diode. Okay, so this is the second method for preventing antenna. Okay, how the diode is preventing antenna, in the sense I'll tell you. See, the charges will be accumulated in the metal. See, the entire charges is accumulated, and the charges will flow through this part of the area, and before it is going to the gate oxide area, the diode, what the diode will do, it will go to the reverse break, it will break the reverse bias junction, it will go to the reverse breakdown region, and it will discharge all the charges to the ground. Before affecting the gate, it will discharge through the diode. So that's why we are placing the diode here nearby to the gate area. Okay, because the entire charges accumulated in this area, the diode has to collect. Suppose if you place the diode in this place, only the diode will collect the charges from only this area only, because the charges is accumulated here and the charges will come and discharge in this area. What about the charges present in here? It may affect the gate, it may affect, it may not affect, but it may affect the gate area. That is why we are placing the antenna diode to the nearby gate terminal. And in cross sectional view, how that antenna diode will be there, in the sense here I am drawing, you can easily understand. See, this is P region, this is P region, this is a gate region, and this is a gate poly. So this is the gate region, this is gate oxide. So what they will do at the time of doing manufacturing, usually it's a PNP, right? So here we have one N well, so this is N well, so N well, and this is P minus. So usually whatever it is, even though if it is a P mass or N mass, what they will do here, they will implant on N implantation. So one N plus implantation. So these N plus and P plus is the reverse bias structure. This is the gate connection. So here they will connect this N region to the gate terminal. Suppose if there is any charges accumulated in this part, so it will come. The PN junction diode will be go to the reverse bias condition. Whenever it is crossing the reverse breakdown voltage, the diode will start conduct through the P substrate, all the charges will be discharged to the ground. So this is a N diode. So why we are going for the N diode? It is very easy to make a PN junction diode. Suppose if you want to place P diode, again you have to place one more N well. So that will be very complicated because N diode need one more separate biasing and all. So this is N diode, not P diode. This is N diode. Okay. So usually we are using N diode. So N diode, it's a manufacturing wise N diode, it's very easy. See, generally we have a P substrate, it's a global substrate. So one more N diode if you implanting, so PN junction diode easily we can form, and it won't affect, it won't take any too much area also. Okay, so within some certain area also we can place it. So this is the one more method to prevent antenna. It's adding reverse bias diode. So this is a second method. And third method is adding dummy. Okay, adding dummy, what will do usually, if you add the dummy device, the gate area, oxide area will be increased. For example, if one terminal, what is a one device is there, it is having some value of X gate area. If you add one more dummy and the gate of the dummy is connected to the input net, what will do? It will increase 2x. Suppose if you add the 3 dummies, again it will go for 3x area. So the area will be increased while adding dummy. Gate oxide area will be increased. And the source and drain terminal, this is source terminal and this is drain terminal, right? Both you can short and you can connect to the ground terminal, or else the 3 terminals of the gate also. Even suppose in rare case what they will do, this is a gate terminal, and gate and source and drain, 3 terminal, this is source terminal, drain terminal, all the 3 terminals will be shorted and it will be connected to the input net. See, it will be connected to the input net. So that time it can act as a normal dummy diode. And one more method is there, the gate has to connect to the ground metal, and source and drain also you can connect through the input signal, which means the metal which is connected to the, this is active mass. See, this is active region, sorry, this is the active device. This is active device. Before or after? Before only we have to add, because the dummy has to collect the charges, right? So we shouldn't add the dummy device next right side of the active area. We have to add the dummy device before. So whatever the charges accumulated here, the dummy will get affected. The dummy will prevent the breakdown of the gate oxide region. So adding the dummy will prevent antenna effect. So this is a third method. So only 3 methods are there to prevent antenna. And one more thing, in few of the cases, top metals will not affected by the antenna. So it's a general theory. So top metals will not affected from the antenna, which means above M3, below M3 only, M3, M1, M2, these are all the metals only, usually it will affect from the antenna. After M3, M4, M5, M6, up to M12, the metals will not affect from the antenna. Do you know why? I'll tell you the answers. See, suppose if you go for the higher metal, see, for example, we are here, we are using up to M3 metal, we are using to connect to the gate and one more gate of the transistor, or else some more, see, this is the input and this is coming and this is going and connecting to the one more gate. So what will happen? Usually while going higher metals, we are splitting the metals. See, while manufacturing M1, only this area is there, only this area. So we have up to this area, so we have to calculate the antenna ratio formula by using the antenna ratio formula. See, only the metal area is only this much, so it will not affect antenna. Here one more floating M1 is there, which means this is a floating net, but this is not connected to here because it's a empty open. See, this is open space. Again, once M1 manufacture, we are going for M2, so that time the M2 metal only we have to calculate. So only this much area. Suppose again if it is not affected from the antenna, then it's okay. Suppose if it is affecting from the antenna, what we have to do, we have to split the metal. Here also we have to split the metal. Only instead of going for such a huge metal, we have to draw the metal only up to this area only. again we have to go for M3 method. See, the discharged path through the antenna, it's going and M1 to M2, M2 to M3, again M3, again M1. So it has to go to lower metal to higher metal and higher metal to lower metal. So each and every metal fabrication process, they will do planarization. So at the time of planarization, the entire charges will be discharged, and maximum the charges induced in the metal place, it's very low. It depends on the area, how lengthy metal. See, here we are not connecting a single lengthy metal to the gate of the any transistor. We are connecting only the small metal, and we are going for higher metal. So this is the reason what you would say, higher metal will not affect antenna area. And one more thing is there, in top metal in the sense TP metal, usually top metal is used for to give power related connection and clock related connections. So top metal, usually they will use copper, because copper is very expensive. See, M1, M2, M3 metal and all, we shouldn't use copper because it's a very expensive. Already if we are using some expensive metals, it will cost the chip, what is it? Again, the chip price will be increased. So that's the reason M1, M2, up to M3, up to M6 or M12 metal, they will use aluminium. And top metal, TP metal, they will use as a copper. And one more thing, manufacturing the aluminium metal and manufacturing the copper metal, this is a totally different. See, for example, this is a figure 1. In figure 1, they are depositing the aluminium layer. What they will do? Initially, in the full die, they will deposit the aluminium. See, they will fill it with fully, it will be fill it with aluminium. After second process, so this is step 1. Again, step 2, what they will do? Where we need exact metal. Suppose we have a metal only this area. We want to implant the metal only this area. We need a metal. So what they will do here, they will apply some photo mask and rest of the aluminium. See, these are all the rest of the aluminiums in the die. So these are all we don't want, because these are all the waste aluminium. What they will do, they will add on photo mask and then they will go for photolithography. Then they will remove the excess aluminium present in the die. So totally this much aluminium we are washing and we are removing this aluminium. Again, what they will do, only this area only we can after photolithography, after etching process, we will get the aluminium metal layer only this area. So to implant the metal area only to this part, we are implanting with the entire chip and we are removing the unwanted aluminium. After that, what we'll do, when the etching process is completed, they will do oxidization. Oxidization is just converting silicon into silicon dioxide. So normally silicon will be there, S, plus we are adding oxidization O2, so it can act as a SiO2. So it's nothing but an insulator. So here the rest of the areas and all will be filled up by the insulating layer. SiO2 layer will be filled up. So that is called oxidization. So this is the aluminium fabrication process. But it is totally different how the copper metals are implanted. What they will do, initially they will deposit with the SiO2 layer. So this is fully, the die will be covered with the silicon dioxide, SiO2 layer. And where we need a copper in particular area only, they will do trench in the sense digging that area. So they will, what they will do, they will add some trench. So this is called a trench. So what they will dig the area and they will remove the oxidization, which means oxide layer. This oxide they will remove where particularly we need a copper. They will do trench. Again, they will fill up only this area with the copper. See, instead of fill upping the entirely fully die with the aluminium, here where exactly we need the aluminium, sorry, where we exactly need the copper metal in that area, they will do with the trench method. Okay, trenching in the sense, see, for example, this is a normal trench in the sense we have to dig this area. So they will dig in the sense they will do some trench. Okay, so they will add some trench and they will fill up the copper into this area. Only particularly this area they will fill up the copper. So the exact uniform structure will be there won't be any etching related problem. And here we are not using photolithography. See, here we are compulsory using photolithography because we have the desired pattern. So pattern and etching will be done photolithography process only. Here we are not using photolithography. Whenever there is no the process of photolithography, we are reducing the cost, because the photolithography alone take 30% of the cost in a single die. because lithography is very costly process. That is why we are not using too much lithography in single die. How much ever we can able to reduce the lithography in any chip fabrication, we have to do, because lithography will take 30% of the cost of the one single die. For example, 1000 rupees if it is required to manufacture one chip, so each and every lithography will cost 30 rupees. I am telling about one lithography. Suppose if the die consider 4 to 5 lithography, we have to multiply into 4. Suppose if there is any 4 lithography, we have to calculate, we have to multiply it by 4. So 30% is 300 rupees. So 4 into 300, we have to spend 1200 rupees if there is a 4 lithography process. So that is why we need to reduce the number of lithography in manufacturing process. And one more thing, in few of the companies and few of the technologies, for example, Global is one foundry, Global Foundry is one separate method they are having to manufacture the chips, and Intel, they are having one separate fabrication unit to fabricate one chip, and Synapses, and so many manufacturing companies are there, Global Foundries, Intel, and Texas Instruments, so many companies are there. And few of the companies, what they are doing, instead of using aluminium as a top metal, they are using, instead of using copper as a top metal, they are using aluminium in a top metal. There is no copper up to the TP metal. Since the M12, M12 and top metal, everything is aluminium. There is no copper involved in that. In few of the fabricated foundries, I am telling, it's not for every manufacturing companies are following the same thing. Few of the manufacturing companies, they are following, every metal is aluminium to reduce the cost of the metal. See, silicon trench isolation is the costlier method, and copper is also costlier. So that is why they are going for a aluminium based fabricated metal in a top level also. So what will do, suppose if there is a top metal also aluminium, the last and final method is adding the NMOS pass transistor. So this is a circuit, how the NMOS pass transistor will connect to the gate of any transistor. So this is the active devices, this is our active device. So before active device, one NMOS pass transistor has to connect, and this can act as a diode. See, source terminal and gate terminal is connected. Okay, so whenever there is a source and drain terminal has connected, so it can act as a diode. So here one more diode is there, diode will prevent the antenna effect, and due to the top metal related problem, which means aluminium they are using, so that's why one more NMOS pass transistor they can add in a circuit in such a structure, so it can prevent antenna effect. Okay, so these are all the maximum methods they are using to prevent antenna related problems. Whenever there is antenna related problem, so these are all the methods to prevent the antenna. Thank you for watching my video. If you like this video, please click the like button. If you want to subscribe my channel, please subscribe my channel. If you have any doubts, please contact us by using my email ID, or else please follow us to my Facebook page. Once again, thank you.